First of all, let me say that Devin Nunes is someday going to be hailed as a great American hero. They tried to destroy that man because he spoke up for good and just and all of the things that you have to speak up for, but most people don't have the courage to do it. He will be someday hailed as a great American hero, what he did.
And joining me right now is that California Congressman, ranking member of the House Intel Committee, Devin Nunes. And Congressman, it is good to see you this morning. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Marie. Great to be with you.
You need to be taking a victory lap. I know better than anybody because we did this every Sunday on my Sunday morning futures program on Fox News, how you came out for 2 years and said, Maria, this is not true. This is a lie. This is what really happened. And you educated our viewers. So thank you for that.
Well, thank you, Maria. It was really critical to have a show like yours because we could go on Sunday morning and we could really talk to the American people with a large audience and be able to stay on a long time. And I think that made a big difference because we could get down into the details of what is now known as Russiagate fiasco. But you're right. I mean, we talked about this for many, many, well, I guess dating back to about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
So thanks for making yourself available and your show. You played a big part in getting to the bottom of all this.
Well,
but we're not finished yet, though.
Right.
I think we have to remember that.
I want to talk about that. And you're the reason, and John Ratcliffe is the reason that I was so sure of the story as well, and why I was able to communicate to viewers that there is a much bigger story. In fact, it's the biggest scandal of our time in terms of what the other side was trying to do to a duly elected president. Let's talk That's about right. what happens next now, Congressman, because there's a good op-ed today in the Journal basically saying, look, if Mueller did not look at the perpetrators, you know, if you don't get to the perpetrators, the fact that they started an investigation into Donald Trump based on nothing, based on no predicate. So where does this go now? You are looking to make criminal referrals in the next week.
Yeah, so I would start with this. The mainstream media continues to ignore, I would say, the people who have been on the Russiagate fiasco for the entire time. I think they're listening. But what I've said my major concern now is that the FBI and DOJ falsely claimed that this investigation didn't begin until late July. We now know for certain that that's not true. We're still trying to get to the bottom of that. Of course, there's still documents that need to come out. But we are prepared and are now drafting a criminal referral. As I think I said on your show a few weeks ago, we wanted to wait until the Mueller report came out so that we could just, if there was anything in there that might be of interest. But I think we're prepared now to at least submit our first criminal referral. We think it will grab everybody that we need to grab to make sure that there's a proper investigation. Done, or at least it's our referral over to DOJ. We can't force them to do an investigation, but we think we will give them the appropriate names and some of the crimes. There may be more that have been committed. And then as we continue to get more information, as more information comes to light, we may have to supplement that down the road. But we think by the end of next week, we'll have this out.
Well, why do you think people miss this so much? Let's go back and talk about what went on here, Congressman, because the FBI started investigating Donald Trump as early as the end of 2015, right? And into 2016, they put informants in there. They really tried to trip him up as much as they could as they were watching him connect with the American people.
That's right. I would say this about you know what some of the biggest challenges that we had is because they used our counterintelligence capabilities, these secret capabilities that are really only supposed to be used to go after terrorists and other bad guys, they actually turned it on a political campaign, and that's where they first went wrong. Now, my estimation is they used what's called counterintelligence because they could keep it siloed and hidden from the American people and from the rest of FBI and DOJ. That's why they used the counterintelligence. They opened up a counterintelligence investigation into the Trump campaign because they could use these secret capabilities. Then, of course, we all know the story about how they went and they went to the FISA court. They misled the FISA court, lied to the FISA court in order to get a warrant on a Trump campaign associate so that they then could get a bunch of emails and phone calls and records into the campaign. I'm really just unprecedented. If you go back a year ago, the fact that anyone over at FBI or DOJ would think it's okay to run one informant, 20 informants, whatever the number is, into a political campaign under a counterintelligence investigation is out of their mind, and it's DOJ run amok.
Yeah.
Anyone who thinks that they can pay, they can take U.S. taxpayer dollars and pay people in the campaign in order to get information, that's DOJ and FBI run amok. Congress should not tolerate it. American people should not tolerate it. The Democrats should not tolerate it. But in all of this, the biggest culprit has been the mainstream media.
Mm-hmm.
The mainstream media nonstop was reporting on this phony issue, taking garbage, and they were in on it from the beginning. Let's not forget, there were many people in the media who were involved in this from the very beginning. They were working directly with the Clinton Fusion GPS, the Clinton campaign arm, the dirty ops arm of the Clinton campaign. Many people in the media were working directly with them. They've known for a long time that that dossier existed, and there's no one, you know, none of the major media organizations would go with the dossier information because it was so salacious.
Right.
Now, why do I say salacious? Because that was the former FBI director's term for it.
Yeah, he said it Jim Comey said it was unverified and salacious. That's absolutely right.
Yeah, so if you go back and look at this, how is it possible you have something so salacious? You have the most powerful investigative unit in the world, which would be our counterintelligence capabilities with the Federal Bureau of Investigation. And you're telling me that you get a dossier, you know, and I've looked at lots of intelligence reports over the years. When I first saw that dossier, I mean, what a joke. Nobody would believe that. That's why the New York Times and Washington Post wouldn't run that dossier.
Yeah.
The Clinton campaign dirt.
Look, the Mueller report is done, but what I want to know is where this goes next. Because as you know, as you've reported and told us many times, the FBI was working on two investigations side by side. One investigation was about potential collusion between Donald Trump and the Russians, which we knew all along was nonsense. And the other investigation was looking into Hillary Clinton and her use of emails. And the FBI wanted to charge her with gross negligence, but they were told, don't do it, right?
Well, there's all sorts of issues with the Clinton campaign arm. You know, one of the things that I think is still out there, or not the Clinton campaign arm, but the Clinton operation as it relates to the destruction of those emails. I mean, clearly there were multiple crimes broken there. It's a two-tier justice system. It's not right, and it's why look. It's why the new Attorney General Barr, he's got a lot of cleanup to do over there. But I do have a lot of confidence in him. I really do. I think he's going to be able to get it done.
So do you think that another investigation is going to start looking into Hillary Clinton, given the fact that she did exhibit gross negligence in terms of emails, classified documents? And then, of course, a lot of people say that that's really where the Russia collusion was. After all, the Clinton campaign paid for the dossier. They used Russian sources to find dirt on Donald Trump. She did sell a portion of the U.S. stockpile of uranium, and her foundation got $148 million. I mean, that's real money. She got it from a Russian company, and her husband made a speech in Moscow and got $500,000. All of this was ignored as the mainstream media tripped over themselves to say it was Donald Trump and not her. I mean, it's pretty incredible that during a campaign you had one candidate with real ties to Russia, the other having zero, and yet it's the other that gets in the headlines of collusion.
Yeah, and not only that, but they investigated the Trump campaign for exactly what the Clinton campaign was doing. Supposedly they were looking into the Trump campaign because they were worried that Russians were infiltrating and giving dirt to the Trump campaign on Clinton, when in fact they knew right in front of their very eyes they had Clinton campaign dirt that they were supposedly getting from Russians. And Christopher Steele, who was the hired gun of the Clinton campaign arm, that was running around in London somewhere, supposedly talking to Russians. You know, we don't know. But, you know, the FBI was willing to take that information and never go do a counterintelligence investigation on Christopher Steele. Maybe Christopher Steele was a compromised Russian agent. We don't know.